National Social Security Fund, NSSF, is a national provident fund whose portfolio stands at 17.9 trillion shillings. However, the fund has recently been marred with allegations of corruption and mismanagement, including the renewal of the contract of its former managing director, Richard Byarugaba, who attained the retirement age of 60. During today's afternoon plenary, Among summoned the Minister of Gender, Betty Amongi, to explain whether savers' money is safe.
We have been seeing a lot of information, a lot of messages, a lot of articles regarding NSSF. We need to find out from the Minister of Gender.
The Speaker also wants the Minister to explain the infighting within the institution that is making bad publicity in the press and denting the image of the entity.
We see a lot of fight on social media, but we need that sorted out because it is endangering the people's savings.
MPs were quick to hail the Speaker over the decision to summon the minister to shed light on the alleged scandal in the Provident Fund, which may be a big risk to savers' money.
Honourable Speaker, the bad publicity arising from the scandals unfolding at the Workers' Fund could as well discourage the potential voluntary savers.
Therefore,
pray, I concur with you that the minister presents the report, or even the Committee for Gender and Labour Social Development get interest in this matter. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Thank you.
However, some members of Parliament remained pessimistic, questioning whether a report by the Minister alone can address issues at the Workers' House if Parliament doesn't carry out a deep inquiry.
In my opinion, I think the problem is bigger than what Honorable Betty Amongi can handle, because the minister, the honorable member, cannot use this money without consent of either the head of state or the big mafias in government. So it is very unfortunate that this money is not there. I remember 2 years back when we had a crisis in COVID, members of parliament enacted a law that these people can get medium term of their money. Unfortunately, to date, they have not been in position to get that money because the money is not there.
Is that NSSF, as a social security fund, had huge corrections and money in reserves. With a corrupt system as we have in Uganda today, I suspect that there must be connivance. We have had a number of these fights. For Parliament to call to summon and seek for a report, that can't sort of the current crisis. The same parliament we are talking about is the same parliament where we presented lists of individuals, Ugandans, who were abducted in drones. But up to now, nothing has been done. Government has not produced any list. They have not accounted for the disappeared individuals. If we are now, we are by then dealing with human beings, what about money?
This government run by President Museveni and his brother and children, because a minister of gender writing a letter saying he's in Kapeka, appearing before General Salim Saleh. And Mr. Speaker, we have had problems even here with MPs. The other day I saw MPs from Sebei stated that they are promoting Muhoozi Kainerugaba is going to in Sebei, and Honorable Chemaswete was there at a press conference. We need to know, Madam Speaker, whether this family is running this country as a family, or we have a head of state.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.